Hey guys, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri. And I thought you'd like a look at this 1933 Ford Roadster. And it's looking pretty sharp in that two-tone. We'll check it out here. As you can see, has a nice chrome bumper up front here. And of course, these had a really impressive grille on them. Very nice. And then you have the Liebing Greyhound there as a hood ornament. Very cool. Paint's looking nice and slick on here as well. And you can see it's got a big set of headlight buckets on it. Very nice. And it's riding on a set of wire wheels with the imitation knockoff centers there. Those look sharp. And I can see some cross-drilled rotors back there as well, so it does have disc brakes. Pretty impressive. And you can see it's got that original style hood that splits in the middle so it folds up. Very nice. And it still has the original cowl vent as well. And you can see the glass and the trim and everything's looking like new. And it's got these nice little swan neck style mirrors. Those look good. And has a tan canvas convertible top, and that looks like new. And on the inside here, you can see that's all been redone, and it's in two-tone as well. Nice little kind of mid-height bucket seats there. Has a, looks like a Grant GT steering wheel, but it's in that Ford Banjo wheel style, so that's pretty nice. And full custom gauges as well. And those are from VDO, I believe. And you can see you have your voltage and oil pressure and temp and 120 mile an hour speedometer. So you got everything you need there. And then obviously they have a column mounted tach as well. And that looks like a tilt steering column, so that's nice. Very sharp. And then there in the center of the dash you have a little clock there, and you may notice the custom pinstriping they've done in there as well. Very cool. And it does have a nice set of door panels and everything. I mean, it's a really nice complete interior. Very sharp. And it is an automatic. You can see the shifter down there. But definitely a well-built car. And while we're back here, it also comes with a matching trailer to pull behind it. And that way when you go to rod runs and stuff, you can carry all your chairs and your cooler and all that kind of stuff. We'll go ahead and take a look at that here. You see it says Rapid Rickshaw on it. But they've done a nice job on that as well. Matches the car perfectly. And at the rear of the car here, you can see another nice chrome bumper back here, and of course you have the hitch to pull the trailer there. And they had the pinstriping on the back of this as well, and it also says Rapid Rickshaw, so pretty cool. I mean, they've definitely done a nice job with this one. And I noticed it has some LED style tail lights. Those are sharp. Has the factory style running boards, but it looks like they've covered them in vinyl, it appears like. And then it has the original style Ford step plates there. Very nice. And this being a street rod, it's actually powered by a small block Chevy with TPI injection. Let me take a look at that here. But, you know, with that TPI on there, at least it'll be ultra reliable. It always started up easily, and they get pretty good power out of them as well. So, and looks nicely detailed. You got the aluminum coated headers, chrome valve covers, even has the polished water pump and pulleys. And you can see they've added an electric fan as well. But looking pretty sharp under there. Yeah, let's go ahead and take another look at the other side of the engine here. It's definitely looking sharp in there. And I mean, this thing should move out pretty good with that under the hood. Here, let's go ahead and check out the specs on it here. Like I said, 33 Ford Roadster. 18,000 miles since it was built. And they have a ton of information on it. That 350 is backed by a 700 R4, so it does have overdrive as well. And it has a 4-gear ram with 370 gears. You guys can pause and read all the details, but definitely a well-built car for sure. And you know, it's an attention grabber. Very cool. Anyway, guys, I just thought you'd like a look at that one. I'm gonna keep looking around and see what else they have, and I'll see you later. Bye.